This video tutorial goes step by step through how to use MolProbity or Phenix to obtain structure validation for your protein or RNA structures. First, MolProbity. Use your favorite web browser to go to molprobity.biochem.duke.edu, as you can see in my search bar at the top. This takes you to a file upload page, where you can either enter a PDB code here to fetch a PDB file directly from the PDB server, or you can select a PDB file to upload from your local computer here. To select a file, I will click on the Choose File button, which brings up a File Chooser dialog. Here I have an example protein PDB file, which is the starting model from the Phenix Refinement Ribonuclease SA tutorial, so I can select it and then click Open to set that file for upload. You will see the name of the file shows up here. Now I can hit the Upload button to upload that file to the server. You will see that MolProbity performs a number of checks on the file to ensure that it is a valid PDB format file. Assuming that you have uploaded a valid file, MolProbity presents some basic statistics about the structure, such as the number of chains, residues, etc. Now I can hit the Continue button to continue back to the main MolProbity page. Once you've uploaded the structure, the main page presents all the analysis options recommended for that structure. The analysis options presented will automatically change based on what step in the analysis you are at. As discussed in our All Atom Contacts tutorial video, the first step for analyzing a structure is addition of hydrogens. Note the warning box that tells you that if your structure already had hydrogens, to ensure that they're all of a consistent length, we remove them from your structure. If hydrogens were removed, there would be a drop-down menu so you could choose your file with its original hydrogens to analyze if desired. In general, we recommend trimming and re-adding hydrogens, so to add hydrogens to this example file, I click on the Add Hydrogens option. This takes you to a setup page where you can decide whether or not to do the automated Assen-Glyn-Hiss flip corrections, and whether to use the electron cloud or nuclear bond lengths. In general, the default options selected for you should work fine, so here I click on the Start Adding H button. This starts the process of adding hydrogens. For most structures, this should only take a few seconds. If you selected the flip corrections, you will typically be presented with a screen that allows you to review the flips MolProbity recommends and allows you to select which ones to keep. For this tutorial, we will keep all of the flips and click on the Regenerate H button. This brings up a pop-up allowing you to download the new file with the hydrogens and the flip corrections. I will click Cancel and then the Continue button to go back to the main page. You will see now that the options have changed on the main page now that you have a PDB file with hydrogens. You will also see a drop-down menu that allows selection of which file you wish to work on. Selecting a different file changes the analysis options based on what's in the file. You can also scroll down to the File Upload section to upload other files to analyze. For now, we will make sure that the model fh.pdb file is selected and then choose the Analyze All Atom Contacts and Geometry option. This brings you to a page that lets you customize your analysis run. Options are presented for the 3D kinemage file generation and for the result charts. Like in other places in MolProbity, the default options are customized based on your structure. For example, since the structure has no RNA residues, the RNA options are turned off. I'm fine with the default options, so I will scroll down and click on the Run Programs button to start the analysis. This takes you to a job status page, which periodically updates itself and informs you about what step the analysis is on. This analysis generally takes anywhere from seconds to minutes to run, depending on the size of your structure. Once complete, this will take you to an output page, which presents the summary statistics for the options you selected. You can see that this tutorial model is poor quality, with almost all of the validation options shown in red. For a high-quality structure, these indicators would be in green. Scrolling down, there is a multi-criterion 3D kinemage file available to download to view in the King software, which I will show separately later in this video. And there is a multi-criterion chart option also. Single-criterion output options are shown below the multi-criterion options. For example, you can see a PDF plot of the distribution of your residues on our 6 categories of Ramachandran plots. Going back to the summary page, Clicking on the multi-criterion chart option opens a new tab containing a residue-by-residue listing of where the problem areas are in your structure. Note that the headers of this chart are sortable, so you can sort by a particular validation type to pinpoint the worst residues in your structure. For now, I will use the Close This Window button to close this tab and return to the summary page. Once you're done with this page, you can click on the Continue button to go back to the main page. Back at the main page, you will see in the Recently Generated Results section that the All Atom Contact output has been recorded, so you can easily get back to those results if needed. You can also go to the Popular Downloads section to download a variety of results files, including the HTML tables, PDF files, and kit images. If you have any issues during your MolProbity run, we ask that you use the Feedback and Bugs link on the left menu to send us an email. Finally, once you are done with your MolProbity session, we kindly ask that you use the logout link on the left menu to help us free up disk space on the MolProbity server. Once you click on the Destroy button, all of your files will be permanently deleted from our server. In order to obtain MolProbity validation in the Phenix GUI, go to the Validation tab in the right panel. In this section, there is an option for Comprehensive Validation by MolProbity. Clicking on this option brings up a dialog box. In the input field for the input model, you can click on the Browse button to bring up a file browser dialog, which allows you to select a structure file to analyze. If all you want is the MolProbity structure validation, this is all you need to enter. Note that there is also a field for entering restraints if you have unusual ligands. Also, there is an option to add a reflection file which enables model-to-data validation. If you scroll down, there is an option to save a kinimage file for King to make the multi-criterion kinimage file with all of the validation markup. This tool automatically adds hydrogens without doing flip corrections, but there are options to specify whether to keep your original hydrogens or to use nuclear hydrogen positions. For this video, we will just run the job with only the PDB file. This will bring up a status box that warns you that you are only running model validation. We will hit Yes to analyze just the structure. This brings up a tab showing the status of the calculations. Once the calculations are complete, a MolProbity tab shows up containing subtabs with all the different results. The Summary tab shows the summary table of the overall scores for the whole structure. There's also a button to open the structure in Qt if you have it installed, so you can see where errors are in the structure. The Basic Geometry tab shows issues with the basic bond lengths and angles. The Protein tab shows the Ramachandran, sidechain rotamer, and C-beta deviation analysis results. The Clashes tab shows the clashes from the all of them contact analysis. If your structure had RNA, there would be an RNA tab with the sugar pucker and RNA backbone conformer analysis results. Additionally, there is an Atomic Properties tab, which shows a simple analysis of the occupancies and B factors of the atoms in your structure. One particularly useful feature for finding problem areas is that in all of these result tabs, clicking on an entry in the list will take you to that residue in Qt. To view a file in King, either open the standalone King software, which is freely available for download from our kinimage.biochem.duke.edu website, or open the version of King that is included with Phenix. Go to the File menu, then to the Open File option and select the kinimage file you downloaded from MolProbity or generated using Phenix, like I do here. This allows you to view your structure with all the validation markup provided by MolProbity. This concludes our tutorial video. If you'd like to read more about MolProbity or Phenix, we will include some relevant links in the video description below. Leave us a comment or send us an email if you have questions or suggestions about other video topics you might want to see.